I want to film a video for the 10% about autonomic dysreflexia. So I kind of need to get some AD in order to document it, which sounds and is a little crazy, but you know, we do what we do for educational purposes. I have my blood pressure monitor. It is a simple one from Amazon, and you're kind of just gonna pull it with your teeth around your arm as tight as you can, you know, like you're auditioning for Requiem for a Dream, and then it'll work just fine. Doesn't have to be perfectly straight. As long as it's on there, it will work. Whew. Oh fuck, are we out of batteries? Let's see where we are. What we're hoping is that I'm slightly elevated and that we can wait a little bit to see where I am in about a half an hour, because I'm gonna need a cath soon. So my blood pressure should slowly creep up. Okay. That's about right. I am 147 over 110. We are at 170 over 118. That's a little high. And I'm not getting, oh, I have some symptoms. Okay. So I can feel the heart beating. I can get the splotchiness. Got it. Okay, I'm ready to make a video about AD. What you really need is an autonomic dysreflexia wallet card. If you go to the emergency room because you have really high blood pressure, they are not going to know what this is. Not everybody is trained in the different intricacies of spinal cord injury. So if you have this card, it at least tells the doctor what is happening to you, how to treat it, and it lends a little bit of cred so that they'll believe you. I will link this down in the description. It's good to have just in case you do start getting AD and you're not able to figure it out. Because if you go to the hospital, you need to be able to tell them what your levels have been over time. Just important to have.